Lesson 8, multiply by applying the distributive property and write equations. Remember, equations have those variables, the letters, that are unknown numbers that we need to solve. Ivan designs a dog park with a grassy area and a paved area. So this is his design. He's got, here's his dog park, rectangular shape. This side is 8 meters. Up here, it's split up. Here's your grassy area, and that's 30 meters of grass and 6 meters of just pavement. What is the total area of the dog park? Okay, so now this is what we call the area model. We're going to be multiplying the 8 with the 30, these two factors, and then the 8 with the 6, those two factors, to get the product. So let's see, how can we start that? Well, we can use the area model. 8 times 30 is, well, 8 times 3 is 24. Add on your 0. Add the other partial product. 8 times 6 is 48. And we get a total of 288 meters. The next question says, how do you use equations to find the total area of the dog park? Well, we would solve for the missing total. And before we get there, so how did you get the equation to find the total area? Well, before we get there, we wrote the equation 8 times 30 to get 240, and then 8 times 6 to get 48. So let's explain what that looks like. All right, so let's do, we have 8 times 30 is equal to 240, and that's one equation. Then we have 8 times 6, that gives us 48. And then we have 240 plus 48 equals M. And when we solve for M, M is equal to 288. It says down the bottom, what expression represents the total area of the park? So basically, we're going back, we're reversing back to like the original problem. When they expect what the expression represents, the total. So what did we start off with? Well, we look up here and we see 30 and we see 6. We have to join those back together. And we are going to make 36 and multiply it by the 8. This was the original problem that they used to create this area model. So you need to put back the 30 and the 6 to get 36 and times 8. So that is the expression representing the total area of the dog park. 5 times 53. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to make our area model. Here's my rectangle. Doesn't have to be to scale, but I definitely want to show that this right here represents the 3 ones. And this represents the 5 tens, which is 50, and we're multiplying it by the 5. All right, so now we need to start making these equations. We have 50 times 5 equals 5 times 5 is 25. Add in your 0. There's our first equation, giving us our first partial product. And then the next one we have is 5 times 3, and that gives us 15. That's our second partial product. We're going to take those two partial products, 250 plus 15, and we're going to get 265 as our product. These are partial products, and we add them up to get the main product. So right here would be an equation here and here. Those are equations. The next side we're going to use is our distributive property. So we're going to put 5 times 50 plus 3. And now we're going to distribute that 5, and we're going to give that 50 the 5. All right, 50, get ready to get the 5 multiplied with you. So 50 times 5, your first equation is 250. Okay, that's our first partial product. Next one we have is 5 times 3. We're distributing the 5 to the 3 to get 15. That's our second partial product. Now we're going to add up our partial products. So what we've got here, let's try it again. Let's do 5 times 50. Ugh, sorry. My screen is being a little silly today. Here we go. Plus 5 times 3, get 250, plus 15 to get 265. 83 times 5. Okay, we're going to set up with using an area model. All right, again, it's not up to scale, but we're going to show that one side is going to be bigger than the other, because in the ones, we only have 3 ones, and in the tens, we have 8 tens, which is 80, and we're multiplying this by 5. Okay, so let's start setting up our equations. So we've got 80 times 5, and this gives us 8 times 5 is 40, and add on your 0 to get 400. This is our first partial product and our first equation. Then we have 5 times 3, and that gives us 15. Our second equation along with our second partial product. We're going to make our last equation by adding up our partial products to get 415, and that is our main product. And coming on the other side, we're going to show the distributive. So we're going to distribute the 5 to the 80 and the 3. So we do 5 times, a habit, because anytime a number is outside a parenthesis with no sign, it always means multiplication. Okay, so we have 80 plus 3. All right, let's distribute 5 to 80. So we have 5 times 80 plus 5 times 3. And let's solve it. 5 times 8 is 40. Add on your 0. Plus the second one, 5 times 3 is 15. Add up, put your two partial products to get 415. There is your amazing looking funnel. Mr. Jones's rectangular garden is 27 meters long and 8 meters wide. What is the area of the garden? Okay, so we know one side is 27 and the other one is 8. But we need to find, they're looking for the area. So we know that the formula is A is equal to length times width. And if we want to show an area model, and that would be cool. And we're going to show, and we're going to split up this 27. We're going to show one side is bigger than the other. So this is 20 units of meters. This is 7, and we're multiplying by 8. And now we're ready to show our first equation. So we have 8 times 20. 8 times 2 is 16. Add on your 0 to give your first partial product of 160. Then we take the next one. 8 times 7 is 56. That's our second partial product. Now let's make our third equation, 160 plus 56, to give us our product, which is 6, 11, carry the 1, 2, 216. So we have our two partial products that we add up, our third equation, to get our main product of 216. Let's label it meters. Mr. Smith works 6 hours a day. How many hours does he work in 43 days? So 6 hours, and then he works another in 43 days. So one day he works 6 hours. Another day he works 6 hours. Another day. So we know we're going to be using multiplication. And let's use the distributive property to solve for this. We could use the area model, but just to show another way, we're going to distribute that 6 to that 40 and that 3. So let's say 6 times, let's break up 40 and 3. 40 plus 3. All right. Now let's solve it. Let's distribute that 6 to the 40. 6 times 40 plus 6 times 3. So we have 6 times 4 is 24, add on your 0, plus 6 times 3 is 18, and we have these are our two partial products, and when we add up our two partial products, we get our main product, which is 258 hours. Make sure you're labeling. All right, you guys are going to give it a try. Let's see if you can solve this joke. What is a math teacher's favorite season? I know my favorite season. You have a favorite season? Solve the next two problems to find out the answer. 47 times as long as 6 kilometers is how much? Okay, so you need to decide which method you want to use. You want to use the area model or the distributive property? But I want to see, bring in your work tomorrow. If you want to level up. Many of you are forgetting to do that. Second one, Mr. Toons works 5 hours each night at the comedy show. How many hours does he make people laugh for 47 days? Okay, again, distributive area model. Set up those equations and solve, and bring your work tomorrow if you want to level up. What is a math teacher's favorite season? Summer. You get it? Sum always means to, when you add sum, find the sum of two numbers. That means to add them up. All right. Let's have a wonderful night, rest up, and we'll practice the skills tomorrow. Have a great night. Bye-bye.